What's up, guys, and welcome back to Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare 2. And today, oh man, today we're going to be showing off the brand new classes, or at least one half of them. Today, we're going to be showing off the Torchwood. And if you didn't see the previous episode, episode 214, I implore that you do. We went ahead and finished the Trials of Gnomus and unlocked the two new characters that are available in the game, Torchwood and, of course, Hovergoat 3000. And in that video, I asked you guys to vote on which character you would like to see first. Now, there are a lot of voting going on, and it was pretty tied, but you guys did say that Torchwood is what you want to see first. No sweat if you ask for the goat. The goat will be in the next episode, episode 216, so you guys just gotta stay tuned until tomorrow, and then things will work out nice and good for you. But today, we're gonna be checking out the Torchwood. He can take quite a beating with his leaf shield active, and his blazing blast and smoldering madness are sure to force the zombies to take cover, which is good. I mean, his abilities look very interesting. You can see that you can't even choose appearance or gestures just because he doesn't have any customizations right now, and I really hope they change that soon, but who knows, who knows. But you can see in the abilities here, we have Blazin Blast. This blast of fire from Torchwood's mouth is a surefire way to take care of the zombies that are in his path. Then, of course, you have Smoldering Madness here, unleash Torchwood's pent-up rage, allowing him to run faster, shoot unlimited wood chips, and deal furious fire damage. So he's gonna be doing fire damage, and he has indefinite ammo during that time. Then we got the Leaf Shield, which of course is Torchwood takes reduced damage as long as he's surrounded by his protective leaves. Be careful though, he'll move much slower. So it's basically Citron Shield, but he'll also move slower. And then of course, character upgrades, which we won't worry about too much for right now, just because we need to level up the character. But oh my gosh, we have him! This is so cool. All right then, we're gonna go ahead, take some quests, and head on to an online game and enjoy some Torchwood. All right, so here we go. This will be the first time I'm playing the Torchwood class, and it's super exciting. Oh, his fire spawns in before anything else. The only complaint I seem to have so far with the class, and I can't move. Hello? Yeah, there you go. I mean, of course, I haven't played him yet, so I can't say I have too many complaints, but my only complaint so far is that I wish he would look at least somewhat different. Wow, the shot's actually really nice. From Giga Torchwood, the boss. Like, think about this. The Gargantuar and the Giga Gargantuar, this is really nice. Hold on. It's 275 health. Dude, this guy is crazy. Let's go ahead and activate this then. And then I am all blue and fired up now. I'm taking a lot of damage, but that's completely okay. Beat up this goat. Holy cow. Well, I sort of dived in there like on purpose just to sort of see how things would work out on my end. And it seemed to work out. I like the little log here. Because of course, when the rose dies, she drops like a little tiny actual rose. Looks like he drops a little log, which is funny. But what was I gonna say? Like, you know, of course, the Gargantuar looks different from the Giga Gargantuar. The Giga Gargantuar actually has, like, these sunglasses and everything, while here, the Torchwood doesn't look any different from the Giga Torchwood, which is the actual boss that you fight in the game, but he's just a little bit smaller. I was hoping that maybe he would look a little bit different that way. It's sort of this, like, a cool effect, in my opinion. Okay, so this is, like, a close-range blast. All right, now I get the shield right here, and I do move slower with this, but that's totally cool. I don't know where this imp is. Oh, there's another Torchwood. Help me out, dude. Very, very cool, though. Oh, here. Let's just go ahead and start revving this up just because I can. Get that. Destroy you as much as I can. There's some crazy lag happening. But okay. I don't feel like I'm going to be doing very well, at least at first, just because I need to try this out. I need to figure out what strategies work, of course. And of course, if you've been playing Torchwood, feel free to let me know in the comment section below any cool strategies you might have with him. But I just think it would have been a nice touch. It would have been really cool if the Torchwood had its own visual scheme that was different from the Giga Torchwood. And if they add customizations for this character, maybe in whatever is the next DLC update, then that won't be a problem, you know? Then we'll have exactly what we want. You are running. I don't know if you can run fast enough. Oh, looks like you can, okay. I got you over here. Well, we could get to do a decent amount of damage. What's great is that we also have a really good fire rate. Ow, 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 that hurt. Let's just go ahead with this. But this guy is crazy powerful. I haven't heard too many people go on about him being overpowered or underpowered. So hopefully the fact that nobody's complaining means that he's good. Usually that's the thing for this game. If the community's not complaining, then usually he's just right. So that's good. And the same thing with, of course, the goat. So hopefully that continues to be the case. There is a soldier down here apparently that I would like to take out. Where are you at, dude? It looks like there's two Torchwoods though. That's just very cool. I'm not alone in my endeavors. Here we go. Come on. get closer to me, and then boom, I'm using, this is a lot of damage, holy cow. Hold on. Get the shield up, because I don't want to die if I don't have to, but I might end up getting taken out. Oh, okay, there we go. Loud people with loud microphones. I'm just gonna mute the game audio, because they are very loud. But there you go, that's the first game of Torchwood. Hello. Oh, look at our little dance. Oh my gosh, our dance is crazy. Now we just got like a normal cheer, but our little dance is great. But I would really like to see that. Of course, we were talking about it in not the last episode, but the episode before that, we played the new Mystery Portal, which was, you know, Battle of Accuracy. And it was pretty cool. But the idea that we saw was that there was a hint in the preview image of a, what looked like a brand new Captain Deadbeard class. The spooky thing now is that that picture's changed. It got changed back into a Captain Party Man. So they're trying to pull tricks on us. They're trying to make us feel crazy. I mean, now we have the video evidence. Like, you can go back to that video and see that it's not a Captain Party Man at a certain point in time, but now it is. So that's interesting. It was just like a little hidden thing that they're changing now, and I like that. And I think that means that there's gonna be some kind of update coming out that's gonna be a little more secretive. It's gonna be a little bit more, you know, you gotta be on your toes kind of thing. I mean, just like Trials of Gnomus, which was full of secrets, so. I mean, maybe it'll even be Trials of Gnomus Part 2. Like, we have a lot of options to it, so it's pretty cool. Here, that's sort of the thing I've definitely noticed about the Torchwood, is that you get called out in a lot of situations very easily. Because you are very large, you're a very easy target to hit because you got, like, a large head that has fire coming out of it. So, even though you do have a ton of health, you really need it because people are to be shooting you first and foremost. So, that's sort of a big thing. They already captured that point. And it seems like it's hard to secure vanquishes so far. You know, somebody like with a soldier or even an imp or Colonel Corn or Citron, you can see it's like, they have the same, like, physical shooting power and it's very easy to secure those vanquishes. But here it seems like I'm struggling to make sure that they're mine and I don't just end up getting an assist, which is different, it's weird. I'm still trying to figure out, like, you know, like, what kind of class Torchwood is, and it seems like he's sort of the front-running tank. It's not always his idea to get all of the vanquishes as much as it is. I love how it almost has a chainsaw sound to it. That's very peculiar, but also very cool. And it's like, even there, I just, like, you know, unloaded on the engineer, and I couldn't quite take him out. So that's an interesting situation that I'm a little curious about. Like, I don't know how low I ended up getting him there. But it feels like he's supposed to be the front-running tank in many ways. You know, he might not be the one getting the vanquishes, but he's gonna be the one protecting the sunflower and everybody. That way, you know, you can, the rest of the team can get other stuff done. Like, I feel like he might actually be much better in Herbal Assault opposed to Gardens and Graveyards, what we're in right now, where we're defending. I think he might actually, like, I can't wait to see if we can try him in Herbal Assault and see if things taste a little different there. And I feel like it's interesting because the goat is basically the opposite. They're supposed to be in the back. They're more of a support class. They're supposed to boost the damage everything. I think people are trying to get my attention, but I'm also trying to take care of this dude. Here, come on, let's get over there. And I don't feel like I'm not using his abilities much right now. And there's another assist. Here, there you go. We're gonna just destroy him as fast as we can. It's definitely not easy staying accurate. And it might just be that I'm bad at the class, you know? But I can only spout my opinions when I have them. And that's the whole idea of the video. This pea shooter is just chilling out. He's not even there. But yeah, it's very interesting so far. I wouldn't say it's a bad class. I really hope though, like, you know, I was saying how there, you know, could potentially be a brand new DLC update to the game that might even be Trials of Gnomus Part 2, you know? That would be very cool, especially since, you know, we already know that chances are there's some kind of new pirate class, because, you know, like, what else would explain that picture? But, maybe in that same update, it would be great to see some customizations both for the goat and for the Torchwood. That would be good. All right then, so let's go ahead, boom. Be a little bit defensive here. We're at level 3. Of course, I'm gonna try my best to play this character until we're at level 10, but at this rate, might take us a little while. We've gone 3 vanquishes so far, and like, for me, that's a little atypical. Usually I'm getting a little more at this point. We have been getting a lot of assists, though. So it's sort of like a mixture. Like, I've been in the brunt of the action all game so far, so I don't really have too many excuses about joining late like I did the first game. So I don't know. I'll have to see. Hello, pea shooter. You might not want to run away just yet. Okay. And I think there's something that's like also another situation. I feel like I'm getting called out alone a lot when, you know, in reality, you know, that shouldn't be what's happening here. I should be, oh, he missed that, the poor guy. And I can't shoot while that's happening. That seems like an easy, oh my gosh. They just destroy me. But it seems like that fire breath does a lot of damage. Like, if I can get in close, that's sort of the hard thing. Like, if I press triangle, seems like we run ever so slightly faster with that on. I know, I just wasted it, blah, 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 but I had to see for myself. I know when you have the shield out, you definitely walk slower. Even though the shield seems to dissipate pretty quickly. Okay, so there's a soldier up here. But it just seems like it's easy to take damage. Like, almost that he takes, oh my gosh, hey, there you go. Like, he has 275 health, so if he got CPG'd, he'd have 25 health left over, but it's only like one or two shots from him. All right, hey, hold on. Oh, that's a lot of damage right there. That worked out pretty decently. I wonder if you really do have to play him similar to Chomper in some ways, but even then, like, Chomper has more of an advantage to play sneakling. I mean, it's interesting that we got Torchwood. I feel like Torchwood was a bit of a wild card when you think about it. You know, like, when we all sort of thought, oh, what kind of new class we can get? I mean, I know the conversation about a Captain Combustible-type character from Plants vs. Zombies Heroes being in the game has been brought up, but never just directly a Torchwood that is just like Giga Torchwood, like a playable Giga Torchwood. So it's interesting that this is what ended up getting chosen. And I'm not saying it's a bad choice, I'm just saying that it's interesting that that's what ended up happening. Yeah, we can get you for sure. You're destroying me a good amount here, but I still got my leaf shield. Got my, hey, can you stop it, sir? Can you, oh, double Torchwood power, we got him, he's going down. Oh no, I'm out of juice. Oh boy. But you get what I mean, I think. I hope. Then, you know, Torchwood was definitely a wild card. Wow, now we have three of them? Holy cow. Hello. I love this taunt, it's great. But, I think, you know, like, what do you thought? Okay, what's gonna be the next plant class? I think a lot of people would lean on a mushroom style class. I know there was talks about there potentially being a jalapeno one, but I mean, that one's a little out there even. Like, I wouldn't expect the jalapeno one to work out, but maybe that's just me. I'll just try to get you a little bit. Damage you up too. Ooh, okay, I got the shield destroyed. That's something, right? That's some kind of progress. I don't see anybody sneaking up behind me. I'm just trying to be sneaky myself. I feel like that's gonna be the best way we can handle most of these situations. Like, I can just sneak up behind you and then fire breath you. Need a breath, man? I got none of them. I only got pain for you. Oh, poor Torchwood. So these guys are trying to hop on this point, but from here I'm able to prevent them pretty well. I'm just sort of waiting for them to plop down. That way I can, oh, just like this dude? Just like this dude. Oh, it seems like the closer I am, I do more damage here considerably. Gotcha. So there's a level 4. We seem to be picking it up a little bit more now that we're, you know, finding out a few more strategies. Even though he has a lot of health, he's not a character you want to be caught out in the open with. That's just sort of the basic fact of it. Here, so I'm going to try, I'll probably pull up the shield in just a second because it just feels like the right thing to do. But that flame breath, for as much damage as it does refill quite quickly. Okay. Oh man, 9 damage a shot is pretty crazy down. I don't know if I want to go down there for him. Oh, especially when I can shoot him from here. All right, he's running. Oh, he got stopped. Good old Chomper. Where are you at, dude? I wanna try to sneak up there, but I love when you're about to shoot, it makes like basically a chainsaw noise. Like, I love that contradictoriness to it. Just typical PBC humor, right? But now we're starting to pick up a little bit in the vanquishes. We got like a 3 or 4 vanquish streak there, which is good. I think I'm starting to get it a little bit more. You guys are having fun dancing around. But I really think that, like, for a class to feel like a completed class, it has to have some customizations. In Garden Warfare 2, it has to, you know, in any Garden Warfare game, you know, 1 or 2. So it's just like one of those things where I really hope that the next update we ever get is gonna, you know, their priority is gonna get some customizations on this dude and on the goat. Like, I mean, I'm gonna go on and on about this once the episode releases of the goat, but man, if we don't get custom shoes for the Torchwood, I'm out. I'm out for the Torchwood. That would be funny. But if we don't get custom shoes for the goat, I'm out. Did you see how cool his shoes look? Like, there is no excuse not to get custom kicks for that guy. They look so cool. I have no idea how the goat plays. I think he's supposed to be some kind of buffing character from what I've seen. People have told me that he, you know, buffs damage. So I'm interested about that. But looks like we're going to push back another point here. Totally cool. I mean, we got plenty of time left in this episode to enjoy stuff, so I'm happy to do so. All right, Operation Dropdown. He doesn't even know. Ooh, come on, get him. No, he's in my way. Come on. Okay, fine. Ooh, come on. Yeah, okay. We still even lost 75 health in that altercation. Like, that's a crazy thing, is that it's just so easy to lose health as this guy. I mean, that maybe that's just a price event. Let's get you for sure. No? I mean, he does a lot of damage, but with this reticle, it's not very easy to line it up. Like, if he had, like, you know, an easier reticle, I could see him being, like, even that would make him significantly easier to get vanquishes with. And not, like, once again, you know, I give these criticisms not because I'm trying to say, oh, he's bad, but I'm giving, you know, just as a recognition that these are things that are happening. That did not do much damage. They said 3 damage apiece, but it apparently did much more. Ooh, come on, come on, come on. Oh, geez, oh, geez, oh, geez, not good. We survived a pretty long time there. I think the main issue is that this wrestling star sort of backed up when if he kept shooting, he would have taken me out way easier. We're almost at level 5. I think we get our first character upgrade at level 9, right? No, it's at level 5 and level 9. Well, of course, our first one will be a health regeneration delay upgrade, but honestly, that's not all that, you know, bad for a class like this. Ooh, I can get you. Yep, or that was just an assist. Just never getting enough damage in there. Ooh, these guys running around for sure. I would love to try this guy. You know, and that's something I might end up doing, is trying in all 4 Torchwood Garden Ops. I feel like that's something some people have requested. That might be fun to try. What are you guys' thoughts on that, though? If you have any cool Garden Op, you know, Garden or Graveyard Ops, Solo Ops kind of ideas, of course, I'm working on more Solo Ops combination videos very soon, and wanna, no, come on, so uncool. Okay, fine, I'm just gonna duke it out with him as much as I possibly can. It's, oh, he's running. Once again, once the characters get psyched down and start running, that's when they start losing. Like, he could have gotten me there if he just, you know, just kept shooting for an extra 2 seconds, but then, because he started running away, he just, I guess, I think that's really just the lack of education on Torchwood's abilities right now, because only so many people have him in the game. Like, maybe that person just doesn't know too much about Torchwood and that's why they ran, but if they knew about Torchwood a little bit more, I think that they would have kept shooting there and they would have gotten me. So that's an interesting little perk. Come on, no, I'm just an inch away. It's so slow. Oh man, I'm so dead. So dead. Got you though. All I want is one person. If we can bring one person down with me, that's fine. We'll also be opening up the 30 Rainbow Star chest at the end of this episode, just because, you know, I have 30 Rainbow Stars and I still want to be able to open that stuff up for you. I don't plan on making any more videos on the Battle of Accuracy, simply, oh, come on. That canceled it? I mean, that makes sense, but that still stinks. Just because I don't plan on making any more videos on the Battle of Accuracy, but I still want to show off the prizes you get within the chest as always. So if you want to, stay tuned to the end and you can, get yourself a viewership of the 30 star chest. We'll open up the 50 star chest sooner or later. This will be the first time we open up the 50 star chest without a chance of there being a, you know, a key inside, which is crazy to think about. You know, we've gotten all 4 keys. And I'm working on the new tips and tricks video, which is for Trials of Gnomus part 2, which, you know, I mean, not like the DLC part 2, but if you didn't see, I did a Trials of Gnomus Explained part 1, where I went into how you can complete Trials of Gnomus if you don't know, and part 2 will be out soon now that we've, you know, completely completed everything. Oh, excuse me, pardon me, maybe. Here, come on, just go into, oh man, perfect timing for the imp, the worst timing ever for me. I was trying to go into the flame breath. See, like, them being all clumped up is probably the best situation when it comes to, what's it called? Getting this flame breath to really work, but getting in that position is the hard part. Positioning seems to be really tough for this guy. He's not the fastest character, he's a little bulking, all that kind of stuff stacks up in a very negative way at times. Ooh, he doesn't have a way to quickly travel from point A to B, you know? It's like he sees that kind of stuff, it's like the engineer does a lot of damage and he's a little slow at running, but he has a teleport, so it's fine. Same thing with Chomper, you know, he doesn't have a teleport, but he can dig. So there's this maneuverability available that you can work with, but with the Torchwood, you don't have that. You have to run, and that can be a huge detriment. Let's go ahead and get you if I can. But I think the idea that we have new classes now, like, you know, about 6 months after this game is now released. I mean, what is it, is this 10th, 11th? Wow, it's November. Jesus, year's flown by. That means the game's been out for 9 months now. But I mean, of course, the new stuff came out in the, you know, like, you could get Torchwood in the go as of, like, mid-October, right? So, like, it's been about 8 months that the game has been out, and there's 2 new classes now. So that's pretty crazy. Like, it makes me think, I really hope we can see just as much added content another 8 months from now. And we've already seen 2 new variants added, and I hope that now that they've added a bit more content, I hope that this next 8 months is focused on 2 things. Adding more variants would be cool. But also, I think something that's really important is that they have to add more maps. They got a lot of awesome maps in here right now, but, like, I know these maps to death. you know? Not to say that I'm bored of them. Like, I like these maps, but I know them to death. So I think that if they released a few more maps, that would be great, because I think that's just sort of like a nice addition to everything. Ooh, come on. Ugh. It's just so easy to be shut down by an engineer, for sure. I feel like an engineer is really being revitalized here. Like, he's a good counter to the Torchwood. We've been dying more to engineers than anything else. Which, of course, I mean, the engineer is great for setting up teleports, but besides that and any other situation, he's not always the best choice, but that could completely change if there's, like, you know, an influx of a lot of Torchwoods that can easily be shut down by him. All right, come on, come on, come on, because all it takes is to slow him down for just a second. And then once you do that, here, it's just about, oh, come on, I was trying to revive that dude. All right, at least we got the assist, but once again, assist after assist. We don't get a top assist master, I'm gonna be really surprised. Or at least another Torchwood grabs, because there are two more Torchwoods in the game. Like, I don't know like how they're doing in terms of vanquishes, like if I'm the most vanquishing Torchwood right now. And I might as well use this, you know, blue power whenever I can, just because of the fact that, you know, it won't be available. I mean, it'll, like, a new one will be available once I respawn. You know, it's not like something that I have to wait around for. It's similar to, you know, the turret, but it's a little bit different. Of course, I can't use any of my other abilities. I think that if I have the shield activated and I activate the power-up, I think it actually ends up canceling the shield out, which is interesting. Makes sense, because that would be a, you know, a crazy setup going on there. Let's go ahead. Ooh, where'd you go, where'd you go? Here, let's just, and you definitely can't use the fire breath when doing it this way. Come on, oh man, I just wanted to be able to get that engineer, but I can't. So many assists is insane. I feel like sometimes if I were to do this amount of damage as other characters, it would qualify as a vanquish. But that also might be because the Torchwood in general seems to do more damage per shot. So maybe the threshold of actually earning the vanquish is higher? I'm not really sure. I think I should respawn really quickly as well. Here. If I go character upgrades, because we do have that new thing, I don't think it's gonna change too much for us at this point, but it's worth trying. But yeah, I definitely plan on continuing playing this guy until we reach that level 10, and I'll be trying to master out him and the goat as soon as we possibly can. Of course, I'm busy with all the other characters and videos we need to show, you know, just do and show off and all that kind of stuff, so it might still be difficult. Who's shooting at me there? Oh, you are. Hey, dude. How you doing? Torchwood party. But you guys have been just as excited about this as I am, which is awesome. Like, I really want to thank you guys for that. I was worried that when we were finally going to show off Torchwood and Hover Goat 3000, that you guys wouldn't be like, Zebra, this is dumb. You know, every other YouTuber's gotten it already. You know, I don't want to see you do it too. You know, it's like, I was worried that like people were just going to be annoyed with that. But you guys have been super cool about it. You guys have shown the same amount of enthusiasm that I've had with it, which I have a lot of enthusiasm because this is my first time playing the classes and I've desperately wanted to. And it's one of those things where if I literally physically had any way possible to play them earlier, I would have for sure. It's just, you don't have control over it because it's, you know, you just gotta deal with that 75% chance. So let's go ahead and see, like, it's just so difficult to just straight up destroy somebody like this, but I did it without taking any damage. That's good. Here, flamethrower, you, no, come closer, please. Gosh darn it. You run, you walk just so slow when that's happening. That's a really tough part. Like, if you're not exactly in the right position, and like I said, positioning is super important as this class. Look at all of these guys. So many coffin zombies. I'm like, coffin? You know, choking on my own water after I see these guys. That's just a really dumb joke. All right, can you stop throwing stuff at me? Please and thank you. Hey, no, 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 no! Ow. Oh boy. Now, let's just go into super mode here. Ooh, dang it. That didn't work out, did it? This is such an interesting situation, but we've gotten 24 vanquishes. Of course, that's nothing compared to the top vanquishes. And I definitely feel like maybe not an herbal assault or, you know, Gardens and Graveyards like we're playing right now. Maybe it's just that he's not fit for this game mode. I think that might be a big factor in it. I'm definitely gonna be able to destroy you here. Oh man, I almost wasn't able to. We do fire damage when the Smoldering Madness is going on. And the Smoldering Madness makes me think that maybe, just maybe, we won't ever see any Torchwood variants. Like, I mean, when you think about it, it's like, it's interesting, because it's like, while it's awesome that we have a new class, it's like, the Rose and the Captain Deadbeard are definitely suffering with the lack of variants, you know? So it's one of those things where it's like, will we ever see Torchwood variants? I'm not really sure, especially like, Would a fire class really make sense for the Torchwood if his one of his moves is give him fire damage? Would it make sense for him to have a poison class if one of his moves is give him fire damage? Can you have fire damage and poison damage at the same time? Is that cool? Like, you know, like, it's one of those things where it's like they sort of have to reinvent how the game works a little bit to make that work. So maybe we'll see some unconventional variants for the Torchwood that maybe make it so that he doesn't have to worry about the doubling up of that kind of stuff, but I'm not really sure, and he was trying to hop into the thing there. What are you guys doing? Oh, you're pulling the lever. That's what you're doing. Okay, that makes sense. Here, I'm gonna back up a little bit. This guy's not being a pleasure. Ooh, we could just destroy you though. That was good. Right now we got a times three. And we got level 7 too, so that's good. I just love how he flies in the air, dude. He's like, give me a big hug, buddy. This is how he looks. Come on, come on, come on. If I can sneak up on you guys and then just flame attack, flame attack, flame attack. That's good. The leaf shield does work with the flame attack. I'll keep that in mind. Ow, ow, ow. Come on, can I get you? Yes, I can. Times 6 vanquishing, that's the best I've gotten yet. Very good. I think the leaf shield did a lot better that time than I really give it credit for. Look, I wish I had a solid number on how much health it really blocks for you. I mean, I don't for the peel shield, even though, you know, we use that all the time. Just gotta keep that in mind. Make sure to use that before we use the flamethrower. Let's go ahead and get you as much as we can. Like, the fire rate is really good for the 9 damage you're getting there. All right, I'm gonna try to do what I can here. And it's a little difficult, especially like immediately just knocked down to 100 health, if not more. It's a little bit scary. I'm gonna try to sneak over here and get this health. Okay, then thank you, Vampire Flower, I appreciate it. How about we be a little bit more tactical here? Once again, I think that the tactical approach is great for this guy. Like, instead of the sort of shoot now, think later, which a lot of classes, you know, admittedly are, a shoot now, think later kind of scenario. Okay, dude, you're going down. You're trying to take care of that Torchwood. I'm not gonna let it happen. Ow, my face! All right, then, 35, like, I'm happy with that. I wasn't expecting to get that many, but that's what we're pulling in here. They might not actually be able to even win this. I mean, it's gonna be a close one, I think. Or maybe it won't be, who knows? But I'm pretty sure it won't be a close one. Like, we'll be able to win this one. Here. Oh gosh. There's one, can I get two? I can get two. Oh, three. I don't know what the third one was, but I'm just gonna sneak on behind you guys again. Like, I'm gonna keep, whoa, game, you like lagged out. Come on, they lagged out on the cannon shot, and then like by the time it caught up, I was already halfway through the trip. Oh, that's so dumb. That must have looked hilarious to everybody else, but come on, I had a time to be back with streaking everything. So uncool. I'm gonna try to make my way up here then. If that's not the good choice to make, then I'll try to make another one. There is actually you over here, buddy. You know what? You guys are easy target here. If you just slow down long enough so I can do this, and before the time you realize you're actually being attacked, I already got you beat up. Let's pull up the, oh, come on, I pressed R1 like so many times before I got gravitied, and I still didn't get the weed, or not the weed, the shield up. I keep on calling it the weed because there's the leaf shield weed, and this is the leaf shield. So, weird. But it looks like they're actually about to not succeed in this. It might go into overtime, and they might get it that way, but for right now, they got 3 seconds left on the clock. Don't let them bash against, oh, I think they literally just got it. Did they? They did. Wow, that is lucky. Here, come on, come on. Oh, there you go, that's good, that's good. Come on. It would be very cool to see some kind of Captain Combustible customization for him though. Like, I know that some people have been talking about PvZ Heroes customizations making their way into the game, like they're in the game right now and you can hack them in or something, you know, in the PC version, but like nobody knows how they're going to be incorporated to either beat the Rux or some other way. I really hope that we end up seeing, you know, a Captain Combustible customization for Torchwood, that'd be cool. Or maybe even a Captain Combustible variant in general. Like, wouldn't that be great? I think it would be great. What's going on here? Ooh, yo, let's go into our super mode again. Oh man, there's somebody standing in my way. Standing in my way. Okay, come on, come on, come on, come on. Man, you just get so much ammo. Just keep shooting and shooting. We did okay then. You know, we broke 40 vanquishes in a full game. And I think we just about won. Very cool, sorry zombies. Not your day today, some of them are running away. But it is for us Torchwood. Hey, look at how many Torchwood, 3 Torchwoods in one game. Very cool. Actually 4, there's a 4th one back there just chilling out. All right, GG. All right, so we're doing some Vanquish Confirmed now just because I wanted the taste of something a little bit different. Not only that, but it was forcing me to play more Gardens and Graveyards and I just didn't want to do that. But we also have another quest, which is complete three games of Vanquish Confirmed. I wonder if in the coming months we'll eventually start seeing Torchwood and Goat-related quests. I don't think so, but it would be cool to see. Because, of course, you might have, like, quests that are, like, Vanquish 50 people as super brains, you know? Like, you already have that right now in the game. Of course, they're trying not to do that right now, because I think for a lot of people, these two classes are still a secret. They're still something, you know, most people can't obtain. But hopefully, maybe in the coming months, we'll end up seeing quests like that. That'd be pretty cool. Ooh, come on. You know what? I'm just going to go ahead and flamethrower you. That's good. Can I get you? I can. Wait, no, I didn't. Oh, come on. Get you. Gotcha. Get the shield. Pick up that. I mean, the only thing that isn't so great is the fact that we do walk pretty slow, so picking up orbs won't be our forte, but what we can do is, like I've said before, protect the people who are picking up the orbs, and that'll be nice and helpful. There's a lot going on here. I'm trying to shoot away at you, but apparently I missed every single shot. Luckily, we have a sunflower protecting us, which is good. Hey,
no, you don't. Come on, hit him. Oh!
Oh no, come on, flamethrower. Yeah, not dealing with that right now. We got a times six vanquish streak out of the bat, which is pretty crazy. But that flamethrower refills so quickly, which is good. It's also concerning. Like for my enemies and for when I'm an enemy of a Torchwood. Who's attacking me right now? You aren't? Okay, you're running away now. You're attacking a Citron. Let's go ahead, go into our super move again. Oh, I love how you definitely can walk a little bit faster with this, which is good. Pick that up. Keep going with you, and if he throws his engineer sound thing, it'll really get me good, but he didn't, so that's good. Wow, we're definitely doing great right now, which is good, because I was worried we were gonna do really badly, and it was gonna take me forever to get these last few levels, but if we continue like this, won't be a problem. Okay, I need the shield. There's no zombies around here right now, but, oh, there you are. Here, if I could just get you a little bit closer to me, it's hard to keep up with them when they're spinning around you, though. Like, that's honestly difficult. Oh, geez, another one. The shield is still active, and it seems to be helping a lot more than I thought. I feel like a Mega Man boss. Oh, geez, here comes another one. Let's see if we can't get some early shots on him before he can really deal with me too much. I think a lot of people see the Torchwood as just like the plant version of a mech, just running around and doing mech-level damage, but honestly, that's not the case. It doesn't have mech-level health, and it doesn't have mech-level damage. It can't last as long. It doesn't have that, like... That's sort of the thing that's good with the mech, is that like the imp is a good damager, but cannot withstand the heat of battle. And that's why it's a good alternative, like, you know, like the imp has a mech, which is the opposite, where it can withstand the heat of battle, and that's really what you want to do, is get it within there, because that's where it's going to thrive, is in that chaos. And the Torchwood really isn't like that. You throw it on me, man, I'm on your team. I know I might be new here, but I would like some hospitality. Okay. Ooh, come on. As long as you get close, I can do damage to you. Really, what you want to do is keep a little bit of a game of keep away with the Torchwood. Like, if you can do that, like, the more I play the Torchwood, the more I'm going to learn how to counter him and how to play him, and that's sort of the good thing about this game that I like a lot, is that just by playing the character, you'll learn and understand its weak points more, so that the next time you have to go against one, it's much more easier to handle. Which is why I definitely implore that you try different classes. Like, a lot of people will find, like, one or two classes they like, and that'll be all they play. But in that way, it might be harder to learn how to defend yourself. Pick up the orb first, yo. I guess not. We hit level 9 now. I don't know what our upgrade was. I wasn't paying attention. Never am I? Ooh, come on, get you a little bit. We're doing great though. I wasn't expecting to do this good, and we're doing great. 14 vanquishes right now. Okay, buddy, that's not happening. So apparently there's been rumors going around that the goat, Hovergoat 3000, cannot be goatified by the rose, which is very interesting. You'd think it would at least, you know, depower him down, right? Because that's sort of the thing. It's like, it could just remove his cool abilities for a few seconds. Like, I get he's already a goat, but I mean, it's not like, you know, when a rose goatifies super brains, he doesn't keep his cape and stuff, you know? It'd be cool if he did, if every character had their own customized goat. You know, now that I think about it, that sounds awesome. But that's not how it works, so why wouldn't it work that way with the other ones? Actually, I should probably respawn really quickly. Let's see. Respawn, character upgrades. We got ourselves a zoom upgrade, which honestly, arguably, is not bad at all. Let's see how much. I can tell the difference. It might not be, you know, the most, you know, impactful upgrade we'll get, but I'm sure it'll be fine. It would be cool if there were some upgrades that maybe extended the length of his flamethrower or even extended the time, you know, amount of his blue mode. Ooh, here, go ahead and just go like this. Just get super close to him. And really another thing is that you could go into this blue mode just to catch up in distance, and then you could cancel it and go into your flamethrower. Cause you definitely walk faster enough to catch up with people. And I think that's definitely a good strategy you could go into with this. So that's pretty cool. Okay, so there are a few mechs down there. Let's see if we can't, yeah, I'm definitely gonna go into this mode, and we win! Okay, nice and good. Never mind, we're fine. Go ahead and beat me up all you want, dude, you can't get me. All right, that was a good game. It's very cool to see the Torchwood just chunder. He's barely big enough for the pillar. He's just so big, it's insane. So I'm just gonna earn up the rest of my level 10 here in the backyard, just because it should be easy enough. But not only that, but I wanna be able to see if we can't spawn in a Torchwood and just sort of compare ourselves to our big brother in some sorts, right? It really is just our big brother. And that's honestly really cute when you think about it. Well, let's just try to take care of who we can here. Of course, my backyard is not very difficult to, manage beating a bunch of these people up. So I hope that we'll be able to get to level 10 pretty easily. We might actually have to sneak our way in though. Chemist, not a problem. Once you can land those headshots, it's where things work out pretty well. What are you doing, dude? Get out of here, get out of here. Gotcha. I'll just make my way inside. If we end up dying, we end up dying, that's fine. But hopefully, we can teleport back and some Torchwood will pop up. That'll be good. Let's get you. I can definitely see him being good against bosses, which is why I would like to see him in some garden ops. And I feel like that's something we'll try very soon. It might end up being completely a horrible idea to go ahead and do 3 Torchwood or even 4 of them. I think 3 Torchwood and a Sunflower would be an interesting solo ops idea, right? So maybe we'll try that and see what happens. But oh, can I get you? The Kernel Corn's in here. Hello, Kernel Corn. Ooh, get the shield up. And we're surviving pretty well. Of course, my backyard's on super easy difficulty or easy difficulty, whatever difficulty is the easiest in the backyard that you can change with the globe. So it's not like a, feat of strength that we're handling all this right now, but it's still interesting to see. Oh man, he canceled, by knocking me up in the air, he canceled my flamethrower there. It looks like the Gargantuan is pretty good against this Torchwood. We're getting knocked all over the place. We're almost at level 10 though. And then we'll of course open up that chest that I said I would open up. And then we'll be gone. Here, oh, there I go. We survived for pretty long there. Of course, there's not really too much of a way for us to get our health back. But I feel like that's, we've gotten a lot of impressions on Torchwood today, and I think most of them have been pretty darn positive. I don't think there's anything particularly bad with the Torchwood. I think it's just the idea that there are situations where he's not the one you wanna go with. But you can see even in that game of Vanquish Confirmed, there's plenty of opportunities where he is the class you wanna go with. And honestly, that makes me happy. I didn't want them to make these new classes that were so OP that you just had to do Trials of Gnomus and you just had to unlock these guys, or you're gonna be missing out and you're just gonna be beat up if you play anything else, That's not what I wanted out of Trials of Gnomus. I wanted another class that's just as fair and works just as well with the main group that we currently have. And honestly, that's what we got, and that's great. Because this class, I wouldn't say he's overpowered. I wouldn't say that, if you're not playing him, you're not, you're wasting your time kind of thing. It's just another class, and I like that. That's a good thing. We want that balance. We don't want, oh, the class is better than everyone else combined, and that's how it should be because he was hard to unlock. Because the difficulty of unlocking him shouldn't increase his overpoweredness. It should just, make him a more novel character worth playing just in and of itself. But he should still be balanced, and it seems like they got that idea, and they went with it, and that's great. Makes me happy. And I can only hope that Hovergoat 3000 is the same. I really don't know how the Hovergoat 3000 will be, but of course, if you guys wanna see him, all you have to do is wait until tomorrow. For those of you who voted this for me to show him off first, I'm sorry, but at the same time, it's only one day. And here are some Torchwood, so you can see that we are significantly smaller than them, but we do look basically identical. Our leaves are a little bit bigger because our body's smaller, but besides that, we look identical. For all intents and purposes, it's basically the same. The only interesting thing is, Giga Torchwoods or Grumpy Stumpies, they actually have, a stumped fist on their left hand, but here you can see he actually has a designed hand. I don't know what the difference is with that. I don't know if they've ever mentioned why that's different, but I'd be very interested in seeing why that is. If that was just a design choice that they didn't really put too much thought into why it would be different, or if maybe there are some planned customizations that might make use of that left hand. I'm not sure, but I sense some possibilities, Aaron. Let's take care of these three guys and then turn around and beat you up if I can. The range on that is not very big. Yeah, let's go ahead and start beating these guys up. I think we might be able to take care of a boss or two here, like you. And there you go, there's the level 10. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna warp home and try to avoid some of this mess now. Warp home. We'll go ahead and get ourselves a character upgrade, then we'll make our way to that 30 star chest and open up what might be inside. Very cool stuff though, what an episode, and I didn't show this off. Here is the Torchwood in the stats room. Very cool. That empty spot is no longer empty as we level up the Torchwood, the specialist. Very, very cool. I'm having so much fun with him, and hopefully we can continue to have fun with him in the coming episodes where we do different things with him. Like I said, that Solo Ops video, if you wanna, you know, recommend something similar to me, or if you have your own Solo Ops mixture ideas, I'm always listening for those kind of things. But yeah, for right now, there's more motorcycles driving by. But this has just been like the last five videos I recorded, there's at least like five motorcycles to drive by in the video. I don't know why that is, but thank you guys so much for watching. To thank you, we'll open up the 30 star rainbow chest. Soon enough, we'll be opening up the 51. But for right now, we got ourselves, there it goes, it took its time. The blue chest reward, even though in this room it sort of looks a little more green, but maybe that's just me. Can you, sir, back off. Thank you. But yeah, that was a lot of fun. And like I said, we'll be having more fun in the next episode when we play the Super Goat or Mega Goat or Ultra Goat. I forget what it is right now because I'm tired, but you'll be able to know and I'll be able to know in the next episode. But for right now, the Blue Mystery Portal Pack should have two customizations for us. And that is some cool stuff right there. We got the Pinball set, which is an uncommon, and we got the Happy Fun Time set. That one I really like. So we got two pieces of a set, which is very, very cool. But with that being said, thank you guys so much for watching today's episode of Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare Toon. If you enjoyed it, make sure you give this video a like, share it with your friends and family, and of course, comment in the comment section below. If you watch this point of the video, make sure you comment Torchwood Zebra so that you've watched the end of the video and that you are a Zebratastic viewer. But either way, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.